Get ready to meet Mr. Angry Son. This is one of the more bizarre enemies in the game. He's not really an enemy as much as he is an obstacle, since there's really no way to kill him. Though you can kill him with a turtle shell, but it's usually more trouble than it's worth. Oh shit. The sun's attacking me. Oops. I needed that shell. But it's okay, because this level's fairly short. The Angry Sun comes back in a much later level, in World 8, in a much longer and more difficult level. But that's actually one of my favorite levels, I think. It's a lot of fun. And it is a solitary boomerang brother. I don't know where his twin is, but one's bad enough. I shouldn't have gotten hit there, but I did. Oh well, what are you going to do? And we got flower power. The power of flower. Hey, it's Chain Chomp. It's my good buddy Chain Chomp. How you doing? And there's something good over here, I think. Yep. And we can take this shell, come over here. Oops. Well, at least we didn't get hurt. I thought there was something better over there, like a 1-up, but of course, maybe it was in the other block, I don't know. Oops. Oops. Man, I'm not doing very well at all. And there's a bunch of coins up here, I think. Not much else. Oh no. I'm incorrect. There's a pipe. There we go. And if we wanted to, we could hit that pal block and turn everything into coins, but well, why not? Yeah, that's enough. I like how the question marks stop moving on the blocks when you get a pal. That's a nice touch. It's a little detailed like that, you know? And nothing else over there, let's head to the exit. I'm good at getting those stars. I always wondered why it used a dollar sign to indicate how many coins you have in this game. And it seems kind of weird to me, hey, that they use American currency in the Mario universe. But what do you know? I think that's the first time I've actually done that in God knows how long. Years. So as you can see, 1-ups are pretty abundant in this game. I mean, we have 29 already. I didn't even have to try. Hammer! Hammer, hammer, hammer. Let's see, do I want to use that here or do I want to save it for later? Here you get a warp whistle and a frog suit. Later? I don't know. I forget if it's anything good. And we want to fly up here to the left. Some goodies up here. Oh, the next world is Water World. I hate Water World. With Kevin Costner. That was a terrible movie. But I hate Water World in this game too. Mostly because of the big boss bass. It's a giant fish that eats you. Oops. Could have done that a little more gently. Well, where's the pal? Is it down here? No? Oh, there it is. Oh well. I didn't have enough finesse. Hey, the music thing stopped moving when you hit a pal too. Anything worth getting over here? Don't think so. Ho hum, more leaves. doesn't do us any good when we can't carry an extra item with us, like in Super Mario World. Of course, in a way, this is better than Super Mario World because you can carry several items with you. You just have to wait until between levels to use them. I like the inventory system in this game more than the one extra item that Mario World had. It seems more useful. Alright. Keeping my streak up. And another end spade. I'm not going to bother with it. Instead, I'm just going to use my hammer. And all of these boxes have the same thing. It doesn't matter which one I pick because it will always be a froggy suit. The froggy suit is useful in water-based levels, i.e. the next world, and it's pretty much useless on all the other levels. And we just got another warp whistle that we're not going to use. Hooray. Yeah, screw the end spade. If you don't know what's in there, then it's not worth the time it takes. I don't bother with them when I play for fun by myself when I'm not recording. And really, that's basically what this is. I wanted to play for fun, and I thought, what the hell? I might as well record it. Whoa, major slowdown. A lot going on in this level. And you know that block's there because two of the dots there are a different color than all the other dots. One of these things is not like the other. Come on. There we go. And I didn't do that quite right, but oh well. It's just coins. The levels in this game are kind of short, but it's okay because there are just so many of them. I mean, the waves that this game made when it first came out were just, you know, massive. Nobody could believe such a large game could exist. Of course, it would have helped if you could actually save or if it had passwords. But, you know, that just made it more hardcore. It's like, yeah, I beat Mario 3. I didn't turn my NES off for 3 days. What do you think of that? Oh yeah? Well, I beat it in one day. Oh, it's terrible. The king is shooting silk out of his ass. Please find the magic wand so we can perform unmentionable acts upon him. I don't know if I've beaten Mario 3 all the way through in one day without using any warps. It's a pretty daunting task, really. Especially the later levels. Luckily, unlike more of the unforgiving games of the time, if you died, you could just continue from the beginning of that world, and you had pretty sure you had unlimited continues. I don't want that flower. I have a tail. Tails are vastly superior. I forget if you have unlimited continues or if it limits you to like 3. I think it might limit you to 3. It's been so long since I've had to continue. Oops. Yeah, when I was a kid I went crazy over that anchor. It was the one item in the game I always missed. I could never figure out how to get it. Of course, the way the game manual described it, I thought it stopped the ship from scrolling, which would be a lot more useful than what it really does. If it stopped the ship from scrolling, then that'd be pretty cool. You wouldn't have to worry about getting squashed in some of the tough later levels where the ship moves really fast. Oh, thank heavens, I'm not a spider anymore. My ass was killing me. Although secretly, I kinda liked it. Alright, too much information. Give me my freaking letter. Greetings, you can stomp on enemies using Goomba Shoe. I don't know why she tells you that, because that's only in like one level in the game. What good does that do me? Oh well, that's about it, and I'll see you next time on Let's Play Super Mario Bros. 3.